Students, today we are going to discuss about female reproductive system. So the female reproductive system consists of a pair of ovaries, which are the primary sex organ, female sex organ, and accessory ducts and external genitalia. The main female reproductive part system of pair of ovaries, accessory duct along with external genitalia. And the functioning of female reproductive system is correlate with the functioning of mammary gland. That is, the development of female reproductive system is correlated with the development of mammary gland for different processes like ovulation, fertilization, pregnancy and childcare. So the functioning are correlated. First we are discuss about the ovaries. So the ovaries are primary sex organ that produce secondary oocyte, that release secondary oocyte through the process ovulation, and also produce steroid hormones, which are primarily estrogen and progesterone. These are the steroid hormones produced by the ovary. And secondly, the position of ovary. So the ovaries are located in lower abdomen part of the female body, and ovary is covered by an outer layer which is made up of thin epithelium, germinal epithelium. And the inner part is known as stroma, which is divided into periphery region, which is known as cortex, and an inner part, which is known as medulla. And next is accessory duct. So the three parts are included in accessory duct. First is fallopian tube, second is uterus, and third is vagina. First we discuss about fallopian tube. So the fallopian tube are paired structure. And length of fallopian tube is 10 to 12 cm. This is fallopian tube. So there are three parts, which are infundibulum, second is ampulla, and last one, third is isthmus. Three regions. First we discuss about the infundibulum. So the infundibulum is funnel shaped structure, and it also possesses finger like projections. These finger like projections are known as fimbriae, and these fimbriae help in collection of ovum just after ovulation from the ovary. So it is infundibulum, which is funnel shape, and it possesses finger like projections, which are called fimbriae, and which help in collection of ovum just after ovulation. And the second wider part of fallopian tube is known as ampulla. Ampulla is wider region of the fallopian tube, and it finally open into the third part, which is isthmus, which have a narrow lumen. And isthmus region finally joins the uterine region, uterine cavity, it finally joins. Now the second region of accessory duct is uterus, which is a single structure. Ovaries and fallopian tube are paired structure, but the uterus is single, and it is also known as womb. And next is shape of the uterus, which is like inverted pear in shape, single uterus. Or uterus finally joins the vagina. Uterine region finally joins the vagina through a narrow cervix region, which have a canal, which is known as cervical canal. So the uterine cavity is connected with vagina through a canal known as cervical canal. And this cervical canal along with vagina forms the birth canal. Birth canal have a role during the parturition. Now we discuss about the layers of uterus. The uterine layer are made up of three, mainly contain three layers: perimaterium, myometerium and endometerium. These are the three layers: outer layer perimaterium, middle layer myometerium, and inner layer towards the uterine cavity, which is endometrium. So first is outer layer, that is perimaterium. Perimaterium outer layer, which is made up of thin epithelium, normally thin epithelium. And the second layer, which has an important function also, myometerium, which is middle layer, and it is thick layer and also made up of smooth muscle. So it is made up of muscles, so it helps in contraction. Third is endometrium, inner layer, which is of glandular layer. Now we discuss about the function related to endometrium and myometrium. So the endometrium is the inner layer, inner uterine layer, which is of glandular nature. So it undergo cyclical changes during the menstrual phase. It undergo cyclical changes. like it break down during the menstrual flow and it regenerate through proliferation and then it undergo secreted natures. So it undergo cyclical changes. Second is middle layer, which is myometrium, which is made up of smooth muscle. It exhibits strong contraction during the delivery of the child, that is parturition. And it has a neuroendocrine mechanism which works during the parturition, so that myometrium undergo contraction and it helps in parturition delivery of the child. So now we have again a quick recap about this topic. So we are discussing about female reproductive system, which consists of a pair of ovary along with accessory duct, and last part is external genitalia. And this whole female reproductive system, the development of female reproductive system is correlated with the development of mammary gland. First, in the female reproductive system, we are discussing about ovaries, which are primary sex organ and release ovum during the process of ovulation and also produce steroid hormone. And the accessory part include fallopian tube, single uterus and vagina. And the fallopian tube consists of three parts. First is infundibulum, second is ampulla, and third one, last one is isthmus. And it finally joins a single uterus. And we also call uterus as womb. And it contains three layers. The outer one is perimeterium, middle one is myometrium, and inner layer for the uterine cavity, endometrium. And myometrium is made up of smooth muscle, which undergo contraction during parturition. And inner one is endometrium, which is glandular in nature, and it undergoes cyclical changes during menstrual cycle. And uterine cavity finally joins the vagina region through a narrow cervical canal. And this cervical canal along with vagina form the birth canal. Okay students, now we are going to discuss about external genital, female external genital part. So the female external genital part is also called vulva, and it consists of five major parts. And the first part is monpubis, which is the outer fold of skin. Okay. It is a question of fatty tissue which is covered by skin and pubic hair. And inner to monpubis there is folding of tissue which is called labia minora, which is the folding of tissue. And inner to labia minora are paired fold of tissue under the labia majora, which are known as labia minora. And inner two labia minora, this is uterus, vagina and vaginal opening. This vaginal opening is partially covered by a thin membrane. This thin membrane is known as hymen. So the hymen often torn during the first sexual experience, or it may also broken due to active participation in some sports like horse biking, riding, etc. But it may even persist even after sexual experience. So hymen is not a reliable indicator of any sexual experience or not. And the last part is clitoris. Clitoris is a tiny finger-like structure which is present at opening at the above junction of two labia minora. This is the clitoris, finger-like projection, which is a rudimentary structure in female external genital region.